Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase Macro course video. Today, we're talking about error macros in variables. So my name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's go ahead and get started with these. So we're going to start out with the macros. The first one is scerrorcontinue, and this one disables default Scriptcase error messaging. So there's default messaging that comes from the database or something, and this one is going to disable it so we can substitute our own. The next one is scerrorMessage. So this way we can send our own error message that's custom and maybe it looks a little bit nicer to the users. And then lastly, our last macro here is it exits an application after an error message. So that one can exit it. And then we have some variables here. So this is the scerrorDelete. So this is a variable that contains an error when there was an error from a delete action. And then the next one's very similar except for an insert. So if there's an insert error, this one's going to contain that error. And then lastly, update. This one is going to contain the error from an update action. So pretty simple. We're going to use all of these in an application to control our own error messaging within Scriptcase. So let's go over to the documentation here and let's look at scerrorcontinue. Let's start with that one there. So it's going to be in the SQL section here, scerrorcontinue. There it is. So all we need to do is tell it which event we want to disable the default error messaging on and then execute it. So there's an option of what we can do, so scerrorDelete, insert, or update. Those are those variables that I showed you earlier, and we'll deal with those in a little bit. And here's an example that we're going to build something similar to this, where we disable the error messaging and then substitute our own error messaging. So let's go ahead and copy this one right here for delete, and we're going to take this over to a form in Scriptcase. So here is a form in our Scriptcase development environment. Let me go ahead and run this and show you the errors that we're getting right now. So I have this set up, so there's some errors on the delete here. So if I click delete and click OK, I get this error right here because a child row can't be deleted. And so this is kind of messy. We don't really want our users to see this. So we're going to substitute this. And if I go ahead and get rid of the customer ID and I try to update this, so I save it, I'm getting a similar error because of a parent row there. So same type of thing. And then I'm getting the same thing on an update if I just click add here. And this, I need to set the correct date here because that's required. So set the date field here and then click add. And there I'm getting another kind of messy error that I want to avoid. So let's go over to our application here and let's change this. So we need to go to events. And for delete, we need to go to on before delete. So this is before the delete where we can disable it. So if we go over to the documentation, we can see that this is done on before delete, before insert, or before update, depending on which event we want to do. So let me just paste that there. So that's delete. So now our delete messaging is disabled. So let's go ahead and click save on that. And let's go ahead and run it here, and then I'll make the same changes for update and insert. So I've clicked delete now. I'm not going to get any error message here, but it's not deleting. I'm not getting any message that the row was deleted. So there was an error, but we're not showing any message. So let's go ahead and do the same while we're at it for insert and update. So let's go to the on before insert here and copy that same line and change the event to insert, just like so. Click save on that and then the same thing for update. So I'm going to click on on before update, copy the same line of code, and then change the event to update. Okay, so now we have disabled all the default error messaging for deleting, updating, and inserting. So now we can substitute our own error messaging here. So let's go over to the documentation again, and let's see how we can put our own error messaging in. So the first thing we need to do is figure out if there is an error. So to do that, we need to use the scerrorDelete macro, or the scerrorDelete variable, actually. So there's one of these for delete, update, and insert. So it's just a variable that contains the delete error, and it's on the onAfterDelete event in the form. So let me go ahead and copy that, and it needs to be in the curly braces. So let me go to the onAfterDelete event, and I'm going to check if that variable is empty. So if it's not empty there, I can display an error message. So that means that there was an error, and I want to display a nice cleaned up error message to the user. So I'm going to check if it's empty inside of an if, and then I need to output a message here. So how do we output a message like this? So that's where the scerrorMessage macro comes in. So let's go ahead and find the documentation for that. So let me scroll back up to the top here of the documentation, and let me find the scerrorMessage. So that's under the control section here in the documentation, scerrorMessage. So let me click on that. Very simple. All we need to do is pass through some text. And we can call the scerrorexit after this. We'll look at that in a second. And it's valid in all these events here, so we're going to put it on the after events. So let me put that in. So there's our text. So let me enter in some text. So there's an error, cannot delete record, something like that. This could be whatever you wanted to show your users. Maybe you need to display a little bit more information, maybe not. Put a period there. So let me make sure I put that semicolon there. Forgot that. And then go ahead and run this now. Okay, so let's go ahead and try to delete it, and we should get our own error message. So yes, we do want to delete it. And there we go. There's our custom error message that looks a lot nicer to the user. And so now we just need to set up what needs to happen after an error. So we can go ahead and exit after an error. So that's the scerrorexit macro. So let's go ahead and go back to the top of our macro page here and scerrorexit. So that's going to be under control as well. scerrorexit right there. Let me click on that. So this one, we pass through a URL or an application that we're going to redirect to, and then the target for that. So that target can be blank or self. And both of these are optional. So we could just exit immediately without any call to another application. Let's go ahead and we're going to exit with a call to another application. So here's some of the options that we have for this. We can redirect to the blank or self. And we don't have to define the URL either. And the default is self if we do not define the target. So let's go ahead and let's copy one of these. Let's actually copy this one down here that's redirecting to our URL. So let me copy this and we can go ahead and take it over to our Scriptcase application and use it. Let me copy that, take it over to our own delete after delete event. And I'm just going to redirect as an example to google.com. Just an easy place to redirect to. This can be wherever, and it could be another Scriptcase application as well. You could redirect back to a menu or back to a page that allows the user to contact the sysadmin or something. So there we go. It's going to redirect to Google. It's going to display the message and then redirect. So let's go ahead and try this for on delete. There we go. Let me try and delete it. Click OK. So there's the message again, click OK on that, and it's going to redirect to google.com, just like we would expect. So that's how we do it for delete. Let's go ahead and copy this code and do the same for update and insert. So I'm just going to copy all this code, and we just need to change a few elements of it, but it's pretty much set up and ready to work for them. So I'm going to go to on after insert and paste it in here and change the variable to scerrorinsert, since this is the insert event, and change the message so that it shows the correct error. And then after update, same thing. I'm going to go ahead and copy it here, change the variable to the update variable, and change the message to cannot update record, just like so. And so now this should work to handle custom error messages for update, delete, and insert. Let's go ahead and try this on update. So I'm going to click add new, or actually on insert, I mean. And I need to set the date here, but I'm going to leave the customer ID blank. And there is our error, cannot insert record, click OK, and it redirects it to Google. So that's how you use these error variables and macros to set up your own custom error messaging and execution inside of a Scriptcase application.